Good day, students. Welcome again to an exciting educational video today. This is Dr. Luisito Masanga at your service. Shout out and thank you very much to those students from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao who are faithfully and consistently watching my educational video. To these students, a warm round of applause to all of you. Mabuhay! Our learning outcomes for today, because our topic is what to do before, during, and after an earthquake. At the end of the tutorial video, students will be able to comprehend emergency preparedness with regards to earthquake. Number two, they will know what to do before, during, and after an earthquake, and some precautionary measures and some facts about earthquake. We have here a literature about coming from volcano discovery, and the title is about latest earthquakes in or near Philippines past 30 days. No? And our country was really shaken. We have, according to the volcano discovery dated January 16, 2021, one quake of magnitude 6.3 in the last past 30 days. We have 7 quakes between magnitude 5 and 6, 31 quakes between 4 and 5, 184 quakes between 3 and 4, and 628 quakes between 2.0 and 3.0. So there were also 131 quakes below magnitude 2.0, which people don't normally feel. So the literature is suggesting us that really our country is really prone to this natural disaster, which is earthquake. And the reason primarily is to equip our students of how, what to do during or before, during and after this kind of natural disaster. According to our reference, volcano discovery, biggest quake is 6.3 quake, South China Sea, 17 kilometers south of Balayan province of Batangas, Calabarzon, Philippines. That was December 25th at exactly 7:43 a.m. And we have also biggest quake today, which is 4.8 quake, South China Sea, 10.9 kilometers south of Calaca province of Batangas. Again, Calabarzon, this is today, January 16, at 6:48 a.m. And the most recent quake, which is 2.8 quake at Philippine Sea, 1.8 kilometer north of Pinamopoan, Leyte, Eastern Visayas, today also at 10:48 a.m. First of all, the question here is that, you know, very realistic is, can an earthquake be predicted? Not unlike a typhoon or a tropical cyclone, our Weather Bureau expert can forecast and predict the arrival of a tropical cyclone. But in this kind of natural disaster, we are referring to earthquake, can it be predicted? Well, according to the United States Government Service, Science for a Changing World, Department of the Interior, the answer is no. Neither them, USGS, nor any other scientists have ever predicted a major earthquake. According to the literature, we do not know how, and we do not expect to know how any time in the foreseeable future. USGS scientists can only calculate the probability or likelihood that a significant earthquake will occur in a specific area within certain number of years. Meaning to say, the literature is claiming that we cannot predict an earthquake. So that is why we have to have, you know, a risk reduction, a disaster readiness. The first question here is, what to do before an earthquake, knowing that it cannot be predicted? But here are some emergency preparedness. Make sure you have a fire extinguisher, first aid kit, a battery-powered radio, a flashlight, and extra batteries at home. So, very basic, no? First aid kit, radio to be updated, flashlights in case there will be power interruption, and a redundancy backup power, which are your batteries. And of course, your fire extinguisher. It is very relevant and very important to have a fire extinguisher at home. Number two, learn first aid. Actually, first aid, the purpose is to preserve life, to prevent further harm, and to promote recovery. And of course, this first aid, we must know, no? CPR or cardiopulmonary resuscitation, and even applying tourniquet, and knowledge about basic life support. Number three, learn how to turn off your liquefied petroleum gas tanks, no, and valves, your water and electricity, your main circuit breaker or fuse box. Make up a plan of where to meet your family after an earthquake. So it is very important you as a family should have a detail where to meet, no, your venue after an earthquake. For example, the children is at school, the father is working, the mother is at home. Okay? Don't leave heavy objects on shelves. They'll fall during an earthquake, no? And then anchor heavy furniture, cupboards, and appliances to the walls or flooring. And lastly, learn the earthquake plan at your school or workplace, no? Especially the fire evacuation plan. That is very important. And you must know your evacuation venue in case of an earthquake, especially in your local barangays. So those are the suggested practices of what to do before an earthquake. For example, there is an earthquake. I hope not. But really, according to our data, it shows that our country is really prone to this kind of natural disaster. So what to do during an earthquake? Number one, stay calm. Stay calm. If you're indoors, stay inside. If you're outside, stay outside. No? That's why for indoors, our local government unit and national government unit are having a nationwide earthquake drill. No? They are teaching us drop, cover, and hold on. If you're indoors, stand against a wall near the center of the building. Stand in a doorway or crawl under heavy furniture. It could be a desk or a table to cover yourself or protect yourself. Stay away from windows and outside doors. Now, if you are outdoors, stay in an open away from power lines or anything that might fall. Stay away from buildings. Stuff might fall off the building or the building could fall on you. So those are some suggested precautionary measures during an earthquake. And to continue, don't use matches, candles, or any flame. Broken gas lines and fire don't mix. Meaning to say, if during an earthquake, our gas lines might be damaged. If you're in a car, stop the car and stay inside the car until the earthquake stops. Don't use elevators. They'll probably get stuck anyway. So if you are inside the building, please use the fire stairwell, no? Or the fire staircase. Do not use the elevator. What to do after an earthquake? Check yourself and others for injuries. No? Provide first aid for anyone who needs it. That's why it is very important that one of your family members must know first aid best practices, especially CPR. Check water, gas, and electric lines for any damages. If any are damaged, shut off or close the valves. Check for the smell of a gas. If you smell it, open all the windows and doors. Leave immediately and report it to the authorities. Or if you don't have a cell phone, you might as well borrow. Especially if you want to be updated, turn on your radio. Don't use the phone unless it's an emergency to preserve your battery power. Stay out of damaged buildings. What to do after an earthquake? Be careful around broken glass and debris. No? Be on guard on this. Wear boots or sturdy shoes to keep from cutting your feet. Now, maybe you have a safety shoes, might as well use that. Be careful of chimneys. They may fall on you. Stay away from beaches because tsunamis and seaches sometimes hit after the ground has stopped shaking. Stay away from damaged areas. And if you are in school or work, follow the emergency plan or the instructions of the safety engineer or any safety authority in the school or work. And of course, expect several aftershocks. For this educational video, we have three references. And thank you for this review of literature, which gives us enlightenment and sources for this educational video. Till next time, everybody, I'll see you in my next video. Thank you for listening. Thank you for subscribing, liking, and sharing the channel.